About a year and a half ago, I bought a camera from Facebook Marketplace for a really good deal, and my intentions were to just sell that camera on eBay and make some money on it because I didn't know anything about the camera except that I could make some money on it, you know, it was a really good deal on Facebook Marketplace, and I was just gonna flip it on eBay. Now, I was getting into cameras at the time. I bought an A7 III. I was really trying to get more into photography and videography, but I still didn't know anything about this camera. All I knew is that I bought it for like $60. It was really cheap, and it was an interchangeable lens camera, which is kind of cool. So before I sold it, I figured I'd look it up on YouTube and maybe watch some videos about it and just learn a little bit about it. But when I went on YouTube to look this camera up, there was basically no videos about it except way back when it first came out, like 8 to 10 years ago. There was literally no new information about this camera besides stuff that's just, you know, obviously way outdated at this point. So after seeing that and realizing that there's not really any new information or new videos or anything about this camera, a light bulb kind of clicked in my brain and I figured I would make a YouTube video about this camera so that I can kind of put some new information out there about it and maybe help people out that are interested in buying this camera but just don't see any new information about it. And so that's exactly what I did. I hadn't really made any camera content on my channel before that point, but I figured I'd post the video and just see if it helped anybody out, see if anybody really cared about it. And so since that point in time, I've pretty much based a lot of my newer content about the Sony NEX cameras. And so of course, that's what I'm talking about, Sony's NEX line of mirrorless cameras. And so like I was saying, I made a video about that camera, the Sony NEX III, and after that video started kind of getting a bunch of views and taking off, I started to look at other NEX cameras and I ended up actually buying a couple more of them, and then a couple more of them, and then a couple more of them. And I just kept buying them, I kept making videos about them, just trying to inform as many people as I can about these Sony NEX cameras and all the different models and the differences and what it's like owning them today, like 10 years after they came out. And so that just brings me to right now. I've helped a bunch of people out and showed a bunch of new people about these cameras and how good they are for the cheap prices that they're at. And now I made a bunch of videos about them and I'm working on making a video about every single Sony NEX camera. I believe there's 10 in total of the main NEX line. And I'm almost all the way there. I just have a couple more to make videos about. But I'm just gonna go ahead and link down like all my reviews of the Sony NEX cameras down below if you're interested in checking them out. But essentially, these cameras start at around like $60 to $80 for the NEX III, which is the oldest and cheapest one. And they range all the way up to closer to $300 right now for the Sony NEX VII. And then everything in between there. So these are really cheap cameras that have Sony's E-mount, which is a insanely popular mount. So it uses the same mount as the A6000, A6400, A6500, A6600, and even the same mount as like the A7 III and A7 S3, except those are full frame sensors. The NEX cameras are APS-C sensors. But anyways, after using so many of these NEX cameras and learning so much about them, I really think they're one of the best beginner mirrorless cameras to buy into because there's just an insane amount of upgradability with them. And so you can buy like a Sony NEX 5N, which I think is like the best middle ground NEX camera. It shoots 1080p 60 FPS video or 24 FPS. It has a 16 megapixel sensor. It's really small, just like the rest of them. And it's right around $100 for just the body. So you can pick up that, which is right back here, along with like say a Sony 50 millimeter full frame lens, which is the lens that's on there right now. And that'll cost you about $300 for the camera and the lens. But whenever you feel like you need to upgrade and get a better camera with, you know, higher megapixels or whatever else you need, you can take a step up to like the A6000, you can go a couple steps up to the A6400, or you can even go all the way up to like the Sony A7 III or A7 S3, and you can still use that exact same lens. So I think these cameras are just the perfect cameras to kind of cheap out on the body at first and invest in glass, invest in full frame lenses. And then if you want to stick to the Sony E-mount, you can go all the way up to a $3,500 Sony A7 S3 and use the same lenses, but get, you know, 4K video, 120 frames a second. And I just find it amazing that before I made all these videos about the NEX cameras, there was really barely any new content about them on YouTube. But if you're a new viewer and if you haven't heard of the NEX cameras, I would seriously recommend just looking into them, watching some of my videos, and consider picking one up, you know, even if it's the $60 or $70 or $80 Sony NEX III. And now, of course, with such old cameras like these, you're not gonna be getting super fast autofocus, although it is pretty decent in photo mode. And you're also not gonna have microphone input jacks for anything like vlogging, except on the NEX 7. They're not gonna have 4K recording capabilities. They're not gonna have, you know, huge high like 60 or 40 megapixel sensors. But really what these cameras are made for when they came out and still right now is just a budget camera and something to kind of replace your phone or like a point and shoot camera for taking your photos or videos. If you want to upgrade from a point and shoot or your phone or just want to get into an interchangeable lens camera, but you prefer to invest more in lenses or you just don't have high of a budget, that's where these cameras really shine. And that's why you should definitely pick one of these up if you get the chance. So that wraps this video up. If you're a new viewer, I really hope you subscribe and like this video if you enjoyed it. And check out my other videos about the Sony NEX cameras or any other budget cameras that I've made videos about. And so I really hope this video reaches as many people as possible to inform everyone about these cameras that seem to be just forgotten in the past. But anyways, that's it for me. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next video.